When we think about digital accessibility and making our documents accessible to people with disabilities, that often means making sure that our content is designed to be compatible with the various types of assistive technology that people may be using. In this short video, we'll be taking a look at how screen reader users interact with documents. Screen reading software helps people who are blind or who have limited or low vision read and interact with documents. Screen readers are also frequently used by people with certain cognitive or learning disabilities as a reading and learning aid. The name screen reader is a bit of a misnomer because the software does more than convert digital text to speech. It allows users to interact with the document, for example, by skimming the headings, interpreting tables and graphics, and following links. Getting a feel for how a screen reader works can help us understand how some of the things we do can unintentionally pose a barrier to people with disabilities. There are a number of different screen readers available, but the most popular are JAWS and NVDA for Windows and VoiceOver for Mac. In today's session, I'm going to be demonstrating with JAWS. When a screen reader user opens a document, the file name and program will be announced by the screen reader.
Jumbo the Elephant-After.Docs-Word. Edit.
Depending on the length of the document, the user will then either begin reading.
Heading Level 1 Jumbo the Elephant : Wikipedia. Heading Level 2 Introduction. Jumbo, also known as Jumbo the Elephant and Jumbo the Circus Elephant, was a 19th-century male African bush elephant born in Sudan. Jumbo was exported to Jardin de Plantes, a zoo in Paris, and then transferred.
Or if the document is more than a page or so, the user can skim the headings.
Heading Level 1 Jumbo the Elephant : Wikipedia. Heading Level 2 Introduction. Heading Level 2 History. Page 2. Heading Level 2 Death. Heading Level 3 Tom Thumb. Heading Level 2 Tufts. Page 3. Heading Level 2 Skeleton. Heading Level 2 Elephant Facts.
Alternatively, the user can simply ask for a list of headings in the document.
Heading List Dialog. Headings List View. Jumbo the Elephant : Wikipedia : 1. 1 of 9. To move to items, use the arrow keys. Introduction : 2. History : 2. Death : 2. 4. Tom Thumb : 3. 5 of 9. Tufts : 2. 6 of 9. Skeleton : 2. 7 of 9. Elephant Facts : 2. 8 of 9. Elephants and Their Characteristics : 3. 9 of 9.
This is why good heading structure is so important, especially for longer documents. Every document should have at least one heading, a heading level 1, usually that's the document title. Major sections should then be in a heading level 2, subsections in a heading level 3, and so on. Logical, descriptive heading structure serves as a navigational aid for screen reader users. The user can also jump from link to link.
Despite public protest, Jumbo was sold to P.T. Barnum, who took him to the United States for exhibition in March 1882. Read more on link Wikipedia :P.T. Barnum. This collection was sold to Gottlieb Christian Kreutzberg's quote link Menagerie Kreutzberg quote in Germany. Page 2. After touring with Barnum Circus, the skeleton was donated to the Link American Museum of Natural History in New York City, where it remains. Page 3. A television program about Jumbo, Link Attenborough and the Giant Elephant, presented by the naturalist and broadcaster David Attenborough, was transmitted on BBC One in the United
States. Or the user can bring up a list of document links.
Links List Dialog. Links List View. Wikipedia :P.T. Barnum. 1 of 4. To move to items, use the arrow keys. Menagerie Kreutzberg. 2 of 4. American Museum of Natural History, 3 of 4. Move to link button, enter. Skeleton was donated to the Link American Museum of Natural History in New York City.
This is why having unique, descriptive links in your document is so important. It's considered best practice to use the name of the site that you're linking to as the link. and avoid long URLs or linking generic terms like click here and read more. Screen reading software isn't sophisticated enough yet to be able to describe the contents of images and other graphical content, so it's important that the document author provide what's known as alternative text, a brief textual description of the image that will be read by the screen reader.
Casanova transported the animals that he had bought from Sudan north to Suez, and then across the Mediterranean Sea to Trieste. A crowd of onlookers cheers as horses pull an oversized cart carrying Jumbo the elephant image 5.48 inches wide by 3.8 inches high in line with text.
This alternative text is usually added to the image properties in, for example, Word or InDesign or PowerPoint. If no alternative text is provided, the screen reader will simply announce graphic or graphic 2 inches by 3 inches. Screen reading software can correctly interpret data tables when there's a designated header row and the table is a uniform table, meaning that it doesn't have any merged or split cells or multi-level headings. The screen reader user can move from cell to cell in the table and be able to discern what row and column the cell belongs to.
Table 1, uniform table, Asian, body shape, concave back, with the highest point at the arch of the back, page 3.
In order to ensure that your tables don't pose a barrier to someone using a screen reader, it's best to keep the table as simple as possible, have a designated header row, and avoid merged or split cells. This was just a brief look at how screen reader users navigate a document. For more information about how to make your documents more accessible, check out one of the digital accessibility sessions in the Tufts Learning Center.